Half-life is a probable amount of time that a radioactive isotope has to decay to half its original fraction. Half-life is an amount of time. So we're looking for a time unit. And specifically, we're looking for the amount of time a radioactive isotope has to decay into half of its original fraction. Let's take a look at an example of uranium-238. So here we've got a substance, and the substance, every single atom in it is made of uranium-238. So we colored everything by red. The vertical axis is fraction, with zero meaning no uranium-238 being at the bottom, and one meaning all uranium-238s at the top. On the left bottom axis is zero time. We're going to start our clock at zero, and the bottom right is going to be increasing in time. So at time t equal to zero, we have 100% uranium-238. Now we wait around for time to pass, and we notice at some point that we end up with half of our original fraction of uranium-238. We still have the same amount of grams, but we have half of the atoms being radioactive U-238, and the other half being non-radioactive lead-206. So we've colored the substance gray to represent lead-206, and red to represent radioactive uranium-238. And this amount of time that has passed, we see that half is colored gray and half is colored red. When we reach half gray and half red, or half non-radioactive and half radioactive, we have reached what's called one half-life, which is the time that this substance takes to decay away half of its original fraction of radioactive atoms. We started out with 100% radioactive atoms, and now we're down to 50% radioactive atoms. That amount of time it takes to decay down to 50% is called the half-life, which we abbreviate as T1/2, called the half-life. Since we're looking at uranium-238, one half-life, or the duration it takes to go from 0 to 1 on the horizontal axis, is 4.5 billion Earth years.